Good morning to everyone. I am Gaurav Gupta and this is our next lecture on class 9 chapter 2, exercise 2.2. Before to start the video, I request to everyone, please listen to me carefully and watch the video from start to end. Today we are going to take some more concept related to your chapter polynomial. What's the concept? Our first concept is zeros. Please read the statement, zeros. What is zeros? I am not talking about a digit zero. I am saying zeros, and zeros is basically a term related to your polynomial. What's the definition of the polynomial states? The definition of the zeros means the value of the variable on which the polynomial gets zero is called the zeros of the required polynomial. Again, I am going to repeat the statement. Please listen very carefully. As we already know, the polynomial we are going to take here a single variable polynomial. Either the variable may be x, y, z, s, t, u, may be any alphabets. But what's the definition of zero state? The value of the variable on which the polynomial becomes zero is called the zeros of that particular polynomial. To understand the concept of the zeros, I'm going to take three examples. What's the main purpose of taking three more examples? Please make a read. This is our first example, this one is our second example, and this one is our third example. Firstly, I am going to take degree of the polynomial. As we already taken, what is the degree of the polynomial? Degree of the polynomial means the highest power of the variable is called the degree of the polynomial. If you look this, the highest power of the polynomial is because we get x square, highest power of x is 2. So that's why the degree of this polynomial is 2. If I say about this degree, the highest power of x is 1, it means the degree of the polynomial is 1. If I say what's the degree of the polynomial of this polynomial, because the highest power of x is 3, x is your variable. So this indicates degree is 3. Why I am taking degree? Because degree specifies how many numbers of the polynomial exist. I am saying right here, degree of the polynomial tells us the number of zeros. It means we are going to find out the zeros. And firstly, we have to know how many zeros of the polynomial exist. So you can give the answer by this definition. The number of zeros is equal to degree of the polynomial. So in this, degree is equal to 2. It means number of zeros of this polynomial is 2. So number of zeros is equal to 2. If I am taking this, so number of zeros is 1 because the degree is 1. If I am taking this, number of zeros is equal to 3. So it's very easy to calculate the number of zero by simply looking the polynomial. If we find the degree of the polynomial, we get the same number of zeros. Now we have to take the definitions. Definition say the value of the variable on which the polynomial gets zero is called the zeros of the polynomial. The simplest example is this. I am going to take this. This is your degree 1. And you know, degree 1 polynomial is called linear polynomial. So this one is your linear polynomial. Now, how to calculate the values of the zeros. Please make a look. If I put x is equal to 2, what's the value of the polynomial? If I replace x is equal to 2, what's the values of the polynomial? This is our polynomial. I'm taking x is equal to 2. I'm going to take x is equal to 2. It means we have to put where we have find x, you have to replace it by 2. So here is x, so here we have to replace by 2. Minus 2 as it is, it means we get 0. So the values of x is equal to 2 makes this polynomial is 0. So this one is the zeros of the polynomial. I hope you understand this concept. Now if we choose another values of the variable, the polynomial never gets 0, because we already know the number of zeros of the polynomial is 1. It means we have only one value at which this polynomial gets 0. Other values the polynomial cannot be 0. Now I am going to take this, our quadratic polynomial, because degree is 2, and degree is 2 means quadratic polynomial. So this is one is x is equal to 1 and x is equal to 2. How we calculate x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2? And I will take the concept how we calculate the its zeros. I am taking x is equal to 1. So now put, we have to replace x by 1. If we replace x by 1, so put x is equal to 1 in the polynomial. Here x, so I am going to put 1. 1 square minus 3 into 1 plus 2. Now square of 1 is 1. Minus 3 into 1, 3. Plus 2. Now 1 plus 2, 3. 3 minus 3, which is equal to 0. It means at x is equal to 1, the polynomial gets 0. So this one is the zeros of the this polynomial. Now take second, x is equal to 2. This is your x is equal to 1. I am taking x is equal to 2. Now we have to put x is equal to 2 in the polynomial. Please put 2 square minus 3 into 2 plus 2. Now 2 square is 4 minus 3 into 2, 6 plus 2. 4 plus 2, 6 minus 6, which is also equal to 0. So at x is equal to 2, the polynomial becomes also 0. So this one is also a 0. Now the question arises, there is exists another values of x for which the polynomial becomes 0, true or false? So I am going to take another example. Suppose you have to choose any value. Let I am choosing x is equal to 0. Now you have to check it. X is equal to 0, it means we have to put x is equal to 0 in the polynomial. So we get here 0 square minus 3 into 0 plus 2. 0 minus 0 plus 2 is equal to 2. So it means polynomial not equal to 0. So by choose any values of x, but the polynomial not becomes 0. So we have only two zeros, and these two zeros are 1 and 2. These two zeros can be easily find out by using factorization, as we already takes, or you know, factorization method, middle term splitting method. You already take some questions in class 8. So by using, we can calculate the values of x is equal to 1 and 2, that's 0. But today we have not to calculate the zeros, but we have to check these zeros belong to the polynomial or Now, again I repeat the concept. In this exercise, we have to check these zeros are related to the polynomial or not, but not calculate the zeros of the polynomial. Please keep it in your minds. In the same case, if I am going to take this, because x is equal to 1, x is equal to 2, x is equal to 2, I already know what's the factor or what's the zeros of the polynomial. That's why I write here. But if you want to calculate, then we have to use some different method to calculate the number of zeros of the cubic polynomial, because the highest degree is 3 and the highest degree 3 is called a cubic polynomial. So this one is your cubic polynomial. Now you can check, verify also. Now I am going to take x is equal to 1. So put x is equal to 1. Now substitute 1 cube minus 1 square plus 4 into 1 minus 4. Now 1 cube is 1, square of 1 is also 1, 4 into 1 4 minus 4, 1 cancel out with 1, 4 cancel out with 4, we get 0. Similarly, you can check x is equal to 2, the polynomial gets 0. So the main point is, what's the zero? Zero is basically the value of the variable on which the polynomial gets zero is called the zero. So keep it in your mind. And next point is, how many number of zeros? So number of zeros is basically the degree of the polynomial. So degree of the polynomial is equal to number of zeros of the polynomial. So these two points you have to keep it in your mind. So please make a note first. Now I am going to take its examples, because examples are mostly put up in your exam. So examples are most important. So before to start the exercise question, I have to take each and every example of the exercise, and you have to do it in your fair notebook also. Now find the values of the each of the following polynomial. It means we have three parts, first, second and third, and we have to calculate the polynomial values. So here the polynomial p of variable x. Now here the polynomial q, because p is indicate the name of the polynomial p. In q indicate the name of the polynomial is here q. In this again the name of the polynomial is p. In this polynomial is a function of x, or in this polynomial is a variable of y, and in this polynomial is a variable of t. So don't be confused, because the variable name and variable may be choose according to the question. We have to calculate this polynomial at x is equal to 1. We already did. We want to calculate the value at x is equal to 1. Means we have to put x is equal to 1 in the whole polynomial and get the solution. So in this we have to calculate p of 1, because we have to calculate x is equal to 1. So we have to put x is equal to 1 in the polynomial. Where we will form x, you have to put it equal to 1. So I am going to put x is equal to 1. Now here 5, again x, I am going to put 1. Now 3 to 1 plus 7. I put x is equal to 1 at every place where we found x. Now solve this. 5, square of 1 is 1, minus 3 into 1, 3, plus 7. So this is 5 into 1, 5, minus 3, plus 7. 7 plus 5, 12. 12 minus 3, which is equal to 9. This is your final answer. Same you have to do in this. Now we have to calculate the polynomial y is equal to 2. So we have to put y is equal to 2 in the polynomial. So what we will got? 3 into all 2 cube minus 4 into y, the value of y is 2, plus square root of 11. Now solve this. 3 into, what's the cube of 2 is 8, 2 into 2 into 2, 8, minus 4 into 2, 8, plus root 11. Now 3 into 8, 24 minus 8 plus square root of 11. 24 minus 8 which is equal to 16. 16 plus square root of 11. This is your final answer. Because this is square root term and this is simple term. So they cannot be add. So we have to put as it is in as a answer. Now look at the third example. We have to calculate at t is equal to a. It means we have to put t is equal to a. So what we will put? We put t is equal to a. For t, we have to put a. So you have to put a where you found t. So I am put everywhere where we found t. T is equal to a. I replace t is a. Now solve this. 4 into a4 minus 5 into a3 minus a square plus 6. Now all these terms are different because in this the highest power of a is 4, in this 3, in this 2, in this no. It means all the terms are different, so they cannot be add. So this is our final answer. Please make a note. So our next example is check whether minus 2 and 2 are the zeros of the following number, and you already know. If the these are the zeros of the polynomial, then if we put it on the polynomial, then polynomial becomes 0. Again I repeat, because the definition of 0 state, the values of the polynomial variable on which polynomial gets 0 is called 0. And we have to check minus 2 and 2 are the zeros of this polynomial. So if we put in the polynomial and the polynomial must be 0, then this will be a 0, otherwise this will not be a 0 of the this polynomial. So we have to do the same process. Our polynomial is p of x is equal to x plus 2. Because the variable is here x, that's why I am writing here x variable. So I am checking x is equal to minus 2. This is our first zero. We have to check it. It means we have to put x is equal to minus 2. So put it here, minus 2, x is minus 2 plus 2. We get 0. It means the polynomial gets 0. So this is your 0. Yes. Answer is yes. Minus 2 is a 0's of the zeros of the polynomial. Now we have to do the same step for the x is equal to 2. Now put x is equal to 2. What we will put? 2 plus 2 which is equal to 4. It means p of 2 not equal to 0. So this is not a zero of the polynomial. So this is not a zero of the polynomial. This is your final answer. These questions are very very easy. Now look at the next example. Find a zero. In this question we have not to check the zeros, but we have to find out the zeros. And in this exercise you have to put find out the zeros for your linear polynomial. It means the degree of the polynomial is 1. And how you calculate the zeros? Please make a note here. Our polynomial is p of x is equal to 2x plus 1. Now we have to put the values of x, but we don't have x. How we calculate the x? We know, because the values of x on which it becomes 0. It becomes 0 means p of x is equal to 0. Now put it here. If you put p of x is equal to 0, if we put 2x, this is our polynomial, and I take this is equal to 0. If I put 2x plus 1 is equal to 0 and solve this and get the value of x, that one is your zeros of the polynomial. So firstly we have to take 1 on the right hand side. what we will got, 2x is equal to minus 1 and we have to calculate x. So we have to take 2 on the right hand side, it becomes in the denominator part. So x is equal to minus 2 is a zeros of the polynomial. Now you have to check it also. I am doing verifications. Is this polynomial is a zero or not? Or we can answer this is correct or incorrect. We can easily check because this is our polynomial and we get polynomial x is equal to minus 1 by 2. Now we know if this is a zero, then if you put it in the polynomial becomes equal to 0. Now solve this. P of minus 1 by 2, which is equal to 2 into minus 1 by 2 plus 1. 2 gets with 2. What we will put? Minus 1? Minus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 0. This is the simplest step. First we have to calculate P of x is equal to 0 and find out the values of x. That is your zeros. And if you want to verify, now then put x is equal to that zeros in the polynomial. If the polynomial becomes 0, it means you get the correct answer. Please make a note. So our next example is verify whether the 2 and 0 are the zeros of the polynomial. So in this, what such a polynomial is x square minus 2x. This is our polynomial. That's, it's very simple because this a type of question we already get. But the solution is our polynomial p of x is x square minus 2x, and we have to check 2 and 0. Firstly, I am checking x is equal to 2. So we have, what we have to do? We have to put x is equal to 2 in the polynomial. So p of 2 is equal to 2 square minus 2 into 2. Now 2 square is equal to 4. 2 minus 2 into 2, again 4. So 4 minus 4, which is equal to 0. It means this is a 0. This is a 0. Next, we have to check x is equal to 0. It means we have to put x is equal to 0 in the polynomial. So put x is equal to 0. Now here we have to put 0 square minus 2 into 0. And you know 0 square is 0. 2 into 0 is 0. 0 minus 0 is again 0. It means this is also a 0. That is it. So now we are going to take this question. Exercise 2.2. First question is say, find the values of the polynomial. In this polynomial is this, and you have to calculate the value. It's very easy. What you have to do? We have to put just only the value of the variable in the polynomial. So what's our polynomial is? P of x is 5x minus 4x square plus 3. Now we have to put x is equal to 0. Now solve this. P into 0, 5 into 0 minus 4 into 0 square plus 3. Now 5 into 0 is 0, 4 into 0 square is 0 plus 3. 0, 4 into 0, 0 plus 3. We get 3. In this we don't have to check the zeros of the polynomial, but we have to find out the values of the polynomial. So the answer will be any number. Please make a note. Now what we have to do? Our polynomial is again 5 into x minus 4 into x square plus 3. Now what we have to do? We have to put x is equal to minus 1. So I am going to put x is equal to minus 1. Here also 5 into minus 1 minus 4 into minus 1 square plus 3. Solve it. 5 into minus 1, minus 5, minus 4, and minus 1 square is plus 1, because minus 1, 1 into minus 1, minus minus cancel out, 1 into 1, 1, you get 1, plus 3.
which is equal to minus 5, 4 into 1, 4 plus 3. Minus 5 and minus 4, which is equal to minus 9 plus 3. Answer is your minus 6. Now solve this. Our polynomial is 5x minus 4x square plus 3. And we have to calculate x is equal to 2. Now solve this. 5 into 2 minus 4 into 2 square plus 3. 5 into 2 we get 10 minus 4. Square of 2 is 4 plus 3. Now solve this. 10 minus 4 into 4 16 plus 3. Now 10 plus 3 13. 13 minus 16 which is minus 3. So this one is your answer. Please make a note. So our next question is question number 2. Find P of 0. It means we have to put polynomial values is equal to 0. Now then we have to put polynomial values 1. Then we have to put the polynomial variable is equal to 2. For each of the following, these are the 4 parts of the question. And we have to calculate these 3 for each term. So it's very easy. We have to just put the value of the variable. Now first we have to calculate P of 0. 0 means we have to put variable is equal to 0. Now the variable is here y. So we have to put y is equal to 0. Now solve this. 0 square minus 0 plus 1. Which is equal to 0 square is 0 minus 0 plus 1. So we get 1. This is our answer. Now we have to calculate P of 1. P of 1. Now put y is equal to 1. 1 square minus 1 plus 1. Now we 1 square is 1. 1 minus 1 plus 1. 1 is cancelled out with 1. We get only 1. Now we have to calculate P of 2. In this case we have to put xy is equal to 2. Now solve this. 2 square minus 2 plus 1. Which is 2 square is 4. Minus 2 plus 1. 4 minus 4 plus 1 5. 5 minus 2 which is 3. So please make a note. Now we have to calculate, this is our third part. Same here. Firstly we have to calculate P of 0. Means we have to put 0. So 0 cube is 0. Now we have to put x is equal to 1. Now if we put 1 cube, again we get 1. Now we have to calculate P of 2. It means x is equal to 2. So 2 cube. And what's the cube of 2? 2 into 2 into 2? 8. Now this is our fourth part. Firstly we have to calculate P of 0. 0 means we have to put x is equal to 0. So this is 0 minus 1 and 0 plus 1. 0 minus 1 minus 1 and 0 plus 1 1. Now 1 into minus 1 equal to minus 1. Now put x is equal to 1. Put here 1 minus 1 and 1 plus 1. 1 minus 1 0 and 1 plus 1 2. 0 into 2 is equal to 0. Now solve P of 2. Put it here, 2 minus 1 and 2 plus 1. 2 minus 1, 1, multiply 2 plus 1, 3. 1 into 3 is equal to 3. This is your answer. Now solve our next this one. Firstly, P is 0. Now solve this. 2 plus 0 plus 2 into 0 square minus 0 plus 2 plus 0 plus 2 into 0 square is 0. Now 0 cube is again 0. So solve this. 2 plus 0 plus 2 into 0 is 0. Please make a note first. Now 2 plus 0 plus 0 which is equal to 2. Same we have to do for P is equal to
1. If you put 2 plus 1 plus 2 into 1 square minus 1 cube. Now what's the result? 2 plus 1 plus 2, 1 square is again 1, minus 1 cube is 1. Now solve this. 2 plus 1, 3, yeah, or 2 plus 1 plus 2 into 1, 2 minus 1. Now 2 plus 1, 3 plus 2, 5 minus 1, we get 4. You can do next T of 2 also. Do it yourself. Please make a note. Our next question, question number 3 is whether verify are the zeros of the polynomial or not. It means we have to check these are the zeros or not. We have given x is equal to minus 1 by 3 in this our first part. What we have to do? We have to just put the values of variable in the polynomial. If we get 0, that the answer is yes, otherwise no. Check it. Our variable values is equal to x is equal to minus 1 by 3. Put it here. Now solve this. 3 into minus 1 by 3 plus 1. Now 3 will cancel out with 3. What we will put? Minus 1 plus 1, which is equal to 0. Answer is yes. Now second case, we have to put x is equal to 4 by 5. 4 divided by 5. Now x, the values of x is 4 by 5 minus 5. Now 5 cancels out with 5, we get 4 minus 5. It means not equal to 0. Answer is no. Because if we get 0, then answer is yes, it is a 0, otherwise no. Now check third, we have to check it. Two parts, x is equal to 1 and x is equal to minus 1. Firstly, x is equal to 1. Now solve this. 1 square minus 1. 1 square is 1, 1 minus 1 is 0. Answer is yes. Now check it, x is equal to minus 1. P of minus 1, minus 1 square, minus 1. And we know, minus 1 into minus 1, again 1. So 1 minus 1, which is equal to 0. Answer is again yes, this is also a 0. Now take fourth part. First we have to do check x is equal to minus 1. X is equal to minus 1. Put it here. Minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 minus 2. Minus 1 plus 1 0 into minus 1 or minus 2 minus 3. We get 0, because 0 into any number which is equal to 0. Answer is no. Now check our P of 2. Put it here. 2 plus 1 and 2 minus 2. 2 plus 1, 3. 2 minus 2, 0. Again we get 0. Sorry, here, yes. Because the polynomial is 0. Again here we get 0. It means answer is your yes. Now take fifth part. X is equal to 0. 0 square and 0 square is 0. Answer is yes, because the polynomial becomes 0. Now check this. Please keep in mind, the term may be any number, any variable, and you have to do the same step. You have to calculate the value of x is equal to minus pi by m by n. Now put minus m divided by l. So this is l, and we have to put x is equal to minus m by l. Minus m by l plus m. Now l cancel out with l. We get only minus m plus m, which is equal to 0. So answer is yes. I hope this type of question will be clear to you. Please make a note, and the remaining two parts you have to do it yourself. You have to do simple steps. Please make a note. So I am going to take our next question, question number 4. Please read the statement. Find the zero. It means the question asked was to find the zero, and we already did it in our examples. How we calculate the zeros? We have to put the polynomial is equal to 0 and solve for the x. So we get the x is called our 0. Again I repeat the concept. If you want to calculate the 0, what you have to do? Simply put polynomial is equal to 0 and calculate the value of the variable. And that value of the variable is called the zeros of the required polynomial. So in this we have to calculate 0. So what we have to do? P of x is equal to 0. We have to put x is polynomial is equal to 0. Now solve this. If we put P of x is equal to 0, we got x plus 5. Now we have to calculate x. That's why we have to take 5 on the left hand side. It becomes minus 5. This is the final answer. As simple. Now this is our fourth part. Step is same. We have to put the polynomial P of x is equal to 0. Put P of x is equal to 0. What will the? This becomes 0 is equal to 3x minus 2. Now solve for the x. Firstly, we have to take this minus 2 on the right hand side. This becomes positive because sign will be changed. And here we got 3x. Now we have to calculate x. Then we have to take 3 on the left hand side. We got 2 by 3. This is your final answer. Now look at this question. P of x cx plus d. Solve same. Put polynomial is equal to 0. Now if this is 0, which is equal to cx plus d. Now we have to calculate x. So that's why I am going to take d on the left hand side. It becomes minus d because here the sign is positive. If we take it on the other side, the sign becomes negative. Minus d is equal to c into x. Now we have to calculate x. That's why c goes to the denominator. Final answer. Now take our next question. We have to put polynomial p of x is equal to 0. If this is 0, we get x minus 5. And we want to calculate x minus 5. Take it on the left hand side. It becomes positive. This is your final answer. Now look at this. P of x is equal to 3. Same. Put P of x is equal to 0. If it is 0, it's equal to 3 into x. Now what's the value of x is? 3 have to take on the left hand side. It becomes in denominator. 0 divided by 3. If we divide 0 divided by any number, we get 0. So it means we get 0. Now solve this. We have to put polynomial is equal to 0. Solve this. 2x plus 5. Firstly, I am going to take 5 on the left hand side. It becomes negative 5, which is equal to 2 into x. Now for calculating x, I have to take 2 on the denominator part. It becomes minus 5 by 2. This is your final answer. Now look at this question. P of x is equal to ax. Now we have to put P of x is equal to 0. If this is 0, which is equal to a into x. Now we have to calculate x. That's why I am taking a on the left hand side. It goes to the denominator part. Again 0 divided by a, we get 0. 0 divided by any number is equal to 0. Please make a note first. Now this, because in this we are going to take a linear polynomial, it means the degree of the polynomial is 1, and please make a note first, then I am going to take examples of the linear polynomial. If you want to write the linear polynomial in standard form, what's the standard form, your general form of the linear polynomial? Please make a note. So
So please make a note here. If you want to represent a linear polynomial, the standard or the general form of a linear polynomial is
P of x is equal to a into x plus p.
In this, you get the highest power of x is 1. Please make a note here. Okay, higher x is 1 means the all examples are your linear polynomial, which is in forms of ax plus b. The highest power of x, the variable is 1. So if we found the general expression for the zeros, then what will be the result? Please make a note.
In this, we have to put p of x is equal to 0. In every case, we put p of x is equal to 0. So we get 0 is equal to a into x plus b. Now we have to calculate x. We have to take b on the left hand side. We get minus a. Now what's the value of x is? We have to take a on the left hand side. We got x is equal to minus b by a.
What is b? B basically your constant term. It means there is no variable associated or connected with any term. It's called constant. We already explained it. And what is a? A is the coefficient of the variable, your x. So by taking negative sign, and coefficient of variable divided by constant term is your 0. You can solve this question as very quickly if you know this formula.
It's very very important.
Suppose I am applying this direct shortcut. What's the direct shortcut is? I know. What's the 0 is? 0 is basically minus of the coefficient of variable term divided by constant. What is coefficient? If there is no term associated, it means firstly make a note, then I will rough this portion and explain very easily how to do on these questions as on this concept. Now how can we do first? Please keep it in mind what you have to take. You, whenever you find 0, you have to take negative the coefficient of the variable term divided by constant, which is your final answer. Now what's the answer is? Negative coefficient of x, there is no term, it means the coefficient of x is 1, and constant term, here the constant term is 5, it means our answer is 1 by 5. Sorry, please make a note first. What we have to do? We have to put first b. What is b? B is your constant term and a is coefficient of x term. So here is, what is constant term? Put it, what is constant term is 5, and variable term is coefficient 1, it means answer is minus 1. Now apply the same concept here, x is equal to minus b by a. What is b? B is your constant term. In this, constant term is minus 5, and which is x. X is coefficient of x. No term is connected, it means 1. Minus minus positive. 5 by 1 we get 5. You can check it if it is also x is equal to minus b by a. What is constant term in this case? Plus 5. And coefficient of x is 2. Negative positive means negative minus 5 by 2. And you can verify this. So this is another method or a shortcut method to calculate the zeros, just by putting minus b by a. B is your constant term. In this constant term is plus 5. In this constant term is minus 5. In this constant term is plus 5. And a is the coefficient of the variable. In this, coefficient of the variable is not specified, it means it is 1. In this, not specified, it means it is 1. in this the coefficient of h is 2. That's why I am taking here 1, here again 1, here again 2. This is the shortcut method, but you have to do it in your fair notebook with the complete this method. Please make a note of. If you really like my video, so don't forget to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes and also press the button of likes. So please do share it with your friends. Then I will prepare our next video for the exercise 2.3. So we will meet as soon as possible. Thank you once again for watching my video from start to end.